DuPont with a shot. Easily handled there by Hoff. Hangs on for the faceoff, which will come to his left now in the left faceoff circle. A special shout out tonight to our boss, Don Boyle, of SportingNewsCT.com. We hear rumor that he's tuned in tonight, so hello to you, Don. We miss you. So the Green Dragons now collecting it behind their goal. Attempt to chip it out, kept in by Lima. Picked up there nicely by O'Connor now behind his own goal. He goes over to Colangelo. Colangelo stick handling nicely out of the zone. He's muscled off the puck there. However, it does get into Kerrigan, takes a shot on goal, and Romano with an easy save there. Squeezes on, hangs on for a faceoff, which will come to his left here in just a moment. 14:22 remaining, third period, Hamden 5, Rams 1. Faceoff now, controlled by the Green Dragons, fired in, shot, Romano. Yes, Romano made that save. Another feed right in front. And taken away there by the defense. Another shot back in. Romano steers it to his right. Controlled now by the Green Dragons. Out to the point. Shot. Romano save. Stick save. Vendetto up to the half boards. Now Bausch takes it out. Skates out. Pass a little head to himself into Joey D'Errico, who overskates it and... delayed offside call collected here by the Green Dragons now. O'Connor skating it up to the red line. O'Connor now chasing it in himself. O'Connor muscles DuPont off the puck nicely. He's a big fella. Number 28 there, O'Connor. Joe O'Connor. He's only a sophomore. He's got some great size. As he picks up the puck again. Spins and chips it ahead to... Barnett. Barnett dumps it in. Taken there by Chris Stevens of the Rams. Up to Richards, who can't quite get it out and now does. Nick Vale through the neutral zone. Races. Beaten to the puck there. The Rams able to chip it back in, however. Puck dumped in deep by Gontarski. Number 24 for the Green Dragons. Vale finding it there along the half boards. Can't quite get it out. Controlled there again by Lynch, who tries to center. No one home for the Green Dragons, and now the Rams able to chip it back out into the neutral zone. And the Green Dragons onside. Stick handle, dipsy doodle there. However, we have a penalty coming with a trip. So... So, Rams in the box. It's like Tommy DuPont. It was a tripping call. Yes, it was. Tripping call on DuPont. And the Rams, he's got 1:30 remaining. 11:59 on the game clock. And now we have a... well, yes, there he goes to the box. So we now have a Hamden penalty. Number 28, O'Connor. That penalty coming with 11:59 remaining on the clock. O'Connor, 2 minutes, and I believe that was a trip call, but we will find that out. Shot on goal, steered easily by Hoff. Nesdale able to intercept that long lead pass to center ice, but the Rams were offside. Now, Carangelo gathering it himself through center ice. Nesdale picking it up in the Rams' end, ahead to... Vendetto. Vendetto skates in the right side, loses control and his stick. Into Zovas. Zovas centering pass, shot. on goal. It was more of a centering pass than it was a shot, but nonetheless, Hoff had to make the save. Now a two-on-one down low here. Shot blocked by Zovis of the Rams. He's able to get the puck out. Green Dragons regrouping. Joey Dierico intercepting that pass. Long lead pass ends up being on goal. Hoff steers that easily to his defenseman there, Pantera. And it looks like another Ram penalty coming. Probably a boarding call. Looks like a cross check. Lots of penalties here tonight, folks. So that penalty coming with 10:37 remaining in the game. 38 seconds left on the O'Connor penalty and 9 on the Cheshire Ram penalty to DuPont. I will get the number of the Ram player here in just a second. It was Joey Dierico, number 15. Hamden now a man down. DuPont bothering Pantera. No, it's not Pantera. My bad. It's Chicoine. Chicoine gets it out to the neutral zone where the Rams regroup. Bausch over to Perslow. Perslow back to Bausch. Bausch skates in the right side looking to center. Loses control of the puck, and it's taken away here by Pantera. Pantera single-handedly racing in. Shot! Save Romano! Pantera gathers his own rebound in the far corner. Centering pass broken up nicely by both the goaltender and a defender. Back out to the point to Perez. Perez dumps it back in. It's collected there by DuPont. DuPont chipping one high off the glass into the neutral zone. Perez gathering the puck up now, races in. He's bodied off the puck by Lima. 43 seconds remain in the Cheshire penalty now as they are on a man-down situation. Green Dragons, obviously in a 5-on-4 power play situation here. Colangelo stick handling, dipsy doodling all the way in. And I believe we're going to have a penalty on Colangelo as he plowed into Tommy Sogolov, knocking the net off its mooring. So that's probably an interference. Yes, it is. Interference call. That coming with 9:02 left in the game. So interference call on Colangelo, number 16 for the Green Dragons. 9:02 remaining in the game. Green Dragons ahead by a score of 5-1. Centering pass, save Romano! It had squirted through his pads as it kind of a change-up shot and was headed for the goal and reached back and made the save. Critical save there. Vendetto tries to dipsy-doodle around a Colangelo who had lost his stick and a shot on goal. Hoff covers up, squeezes it, and hangs on for the rebound. So now the Rams with a power play for another minute 23. And the penalty wasn't to Colangelo, it was to Barnett. So my correction on the name on that penalty to the Green Dragons. Vendetto controlling, shot! Rebound, nobody there. Hoff made the save. Another pass behind. Hard to tell sometimes if they're passing or they're just not accurate shots. Now Hamden controlling it. Minute left on the penalty here. Perslow goes D to D over to Zovis. Zovis skates out, hits Lima at center ice. Lima is loses control of the puck and then it bodied off. And now a long lead pass up to Riscotti. Shot, save Romano. Right pad. flounders out of the zone here. Klanica gathering it, firing it out into the neutral zone where it's controlled there by O'Connor. O'Connor to his D partner. Hamden dumps it in. That's Reagan who fired that puck in. Rams now. Vitali tries to get control of it along the near half boards. DuPont overskates it. Centering pass. Shot save, Romano. From about the height of the faceoff dots. So that was a close in one. Now another shot save, Romano. Big save there. Point blank shot by O'Connor. Richards overskates the puck there for the Rams. Hamden controlling it now. Carangelo, great stick handler. Broken up by Richards, who's able to chip it back in. Riley gathering it up behind his own goalkeeper. Now skates up the right side. He's checked nicely off the puck there by Stevens. Rams can't quite keep it in there. Now Hamden breaks out. Two on two. Shot wide. O'Connor keeping it in at the blue line, and now it looks like it's out here right in front of us. DuPont spins, skates it now, past the red line, gains the zone, tries a little flip pass to himself, still has control of it, tries to center, it's broken up there nicely by Pantera. Big hit there, I think we're going to have a charging or an elbow call there. And there's the whistle. So let's see what we got here. That's an interference call, actually. That might be a kind way to put that one. It's going against Cheshire here, number 23, Tommy DuPont. Penalty coming at 5:37 remaining, third period. Five-one Hamden, 5:37 remaining, third period. DuPont in the sin bin now for the Rams with an interference call. Two-minute minor. Face off now to Romano's right. Not quite controlled by the Rams. Backhand attempt goes sailing over the crossbar. That attempt was by Reagan. Hamden controlling now. Over to Reagan. Reagan back to O'Connor. O'Connor takes a shot. Blocked. Two sprawling saves by... Yeah, two sprawling saves there by Scotty Romano on this power play attempt. O'Connor over to Carangelo. Carangelo dipsy doodling past his Ram defender. Wide shot there by Reagan. Reagan, now it's back out to the point. O'Connor firing it in the far right corner. Picked up there by Rascotti. Shot save, Romano. Back out to Carangelo. Stick handles, looks. Great little stick handling work here. Shot goes wide. It got tipped in front by, actually by a Green Dragon, Kerrigan. Shot save, Romano. Long rebound out above the hash marks. And now it looks like Perslow will be able to dump the puck the length of the ice as the Rams needed a much needed, and we have a hooking call now. Interesting. So we're going to have a Hamden penalty. Getting writer's cramp here. So number three is going to the box. That's Kerrigan on a hook. Faceoff will now come down to Hoff's left. 4:08 remaining. Third period, 31 seconds remaining on the Rams penalty to DuPont. And now Kerrigan's in for a hook for Hamden. So the Rams trying to get their offense cooking here. Still here controlled by O'Connor. He has been all over the place tonight. Sorry, that was not O'Connor, my bad. That was Magson, 23, also a big boy. I saw the size and just assumed that was number 28, O'Connor. Hamden with a couple of real good-sized players out there. So now DuPont chips it ahead to Vendetto. Vendetto looks to gain the zone and does. Stick handling through center, the center slot area. Cavalry arrives. He passes over. Shot. Oh, tipped in front. DuPont was there on the doorstep. Saved by Hoff. Perslow now. Long shot. Actually, that was a long pass to Klanica, who tried to one-time it and hit the side of the net. Pantera now around to his wing on the half boards, and now Green Dragons able to fire at the length of the ice. 2:50 remaining in the game. 40 ticks of the clock left on that sin bin visit by Kerrigan. Long wraparound breakout attempt gathered easily by Hamden. Both benches looking now like they're letting the troops in. Nice stick handled through the D, but he has checked off the puck. Zovis now up to Lima. Lima racing down the left side. Angles in, shot, rebound, and a huge save. Did it get in? It did get in, and we have a goal. So it looks like the Rams, I believe it might have been number 19, which would be Frankie Ilzicki. Ilnicki. Frankie will kill me. So with 2:12 remaining, the Rams get their second goal of this contest. And that was a power play goal. Both the Rams' goals have come on power plays. That's Jared Lawson, now number 4 for the Rams, breaking into the zone. All right, so the public announcement here. That was number 19 for the Rams on the goal, Frankie Ilnicki, with assist by Tyler Lima, number 26, and number 27, Greg Zovis. So a bunch of white shirts helping out on that. Shot and save Romano! Big save there! Right at the edge of the paint. Long lead shot in. Steered away by Chris Stevens. Now gathered over there by Matt Jordan. Chris Stevens now takes it at center ice. He is muscled off the puck. And I mean muscled off the puck by O'Connor. That is a big body to try to get by. Rink-wide pass collected there momentarily by Lynch. Rams gathered up. We are under 1 minute now. 45 seconds remaining. With Hamden with a 3-goal lead now. 5-2. And one more attack here. Puck picked up now by DuPont. DuPont tries to get it out. It's intercepted nicely there by Riley. 25 ticks of the clock left. Ahead to Sean Richard. Richard, look, takes the shot. Glove nicely by Hoff. Some late pressure here by the Cheshire Rams has paid off, giving them their second goal of the game. 19 ticks left on the clock here at Wesleyan Arena. Spurrier Snyder Rink, to be exact, here at Wesleyan University. Faceoff now taken by Matt Jordan for the Rams. 15 seconds remaining now in the game. Vail with a nice centering pass, handled there by the Green Dragons defense. Sogolov checks Riley off the puck very nicely there. And there's the buzzer. So the Rams go down in the hands of the Green Dragons of Hamden here tonight by the score of 5-3. The only scoring in the third period was a power play goal for Cheshire with 2:12 remaining, scored by number 19, Frank Ilnicki, with assists from Tyler Lima and Chris Greg Zovis, number 27. So that'll pretty much do it here tonight. don't have a game total shots, but I'm sure if you were watching, you can see that the Green Dragons pretty much dominated this game shot-wise, if not goal-wise. Next up for the Rams, they face Guilford on Saturday night at 7:30 at East Haven. And next up for the Green Dragons of Hamden, they will face Notre Dame West Haven home at Lou Astorina Rink at 2:30 on Saturday. So that just about wraps it up here as the Rams drop to 1-10. And the Green Dragons, I believe, punch ahead to. I'll get that here in just a second. Right, that brings Hamden to a record of 7-4-1 overall. So, for SportingNewsCT.com and our boss, Don Boyle, I'm Dick Naremore here at Wesleyan University on mic, and Scott Duff on film tonight. So good night, everybody, and enjoy the rest of the hockey the rest of the season. We'll see you at the next game. Good night.